Hello, my lovely people. Welcome back. Okay, too much excitement. Okay, how are you doing today? I hope you're doing fantastic. If you're doing fantastic, let's do a high five. If not, totally fine. Let's still do a high five. Okay? All right, in this video, I would like to talk to you about a healthy team. Let's talk about how to build a healthy team. And what do I mean by healthy team? I'm sure you all are working in a team. Maybe you're working in IT industry, or you're working in educational stream or a medical stream. Whatever stream that you're working on, whatever domain that you're in, you may be a part of a team or you're leading a team, but we're all working as a team. We're all working as one single group for one single vision. Maybe you're not working at all. You may be leading a family. Still, that counts. Your family is a team full of love, a team full of soul. So again, that is a beautiful team. Let's go ahead and see what makes a healthy team, what forms the actual team, right? Let's go ahead and check it out. I'm gonna share a model or a pyramid model of how the team is built, how the healthy team is built. And the foundation of this pyramid model is made up of T-R-U-S-T. Yes, that is trust. If you take trust from the team, you have nothing in the team. How do I know my team? How do I know if the team trusts each other? If you're working as a team, let me ask you three questions. If you're able to answer all these questions, all three questions, you're working in a team where you can trust the other person. And if not, maybe you're going to trust in the future. Okay? So the question number one is, do you know the person or all the members that you're working with? Do you know where they come from? Where are they coming from? Their family background, their location, where are they put up? If you can answer this first question, congratulations. Question number two is, do you know what type of communication do they really like? Do they like phone conversation, or do they open up when they talk in text, or do they enjoy more of emails? What type of communication, what mode of communication do they really enjoy, or do they really understand, or would they really like to have? If you can answer the second question, good luck. Let's go to the third question. What time are they available? What time are they really available? Either in the morning or the moment when I send a text message? Should I expect a message right after I send a message? So what time are they really available? That's the third question. Where they are coming from? What's the mode of communication they like, and what time they are reachable. If you are able to answer all three questions, that means that you have developed a strong sense of trust between you and your team members. If not, no problem. You still have time. You can go ahead and understand them more. And once you know that, once you can answer all these questions, that means that you basically know the person in detail, or you know the person from the heart, and you know you are connecting with another emotion. So that's it. That's the foundation of the team. If you can build that trust, the rest of the pyramid model is going to be so easy. So the trust is the major part in every single team, of course in family as well. So the next portion of the pyramid model, I'm going to check my notes, that is healthy conflicts. A place which is not filled with conflicts means that the place is not growing. Yes, if there is no conflicts, that means the people are doing things on their own. They don't worry about what is your vision, what is your result that you're expecting from them. So when you don't have conversations, when you have that healthy conflict conversations in the team, that means that the team is not growing. What do you mean by healthy conflicts? Is when you have a point, when one member of the team is trying to say, I want to go to this place, and the other member in the team says, I want to go to this place, maybe A and B, let's say. How do a leader or how do the team members talk to each other and come to a conclusion which is the best place for the team? And when you don't have that kind of a conversation, they both think, I want to go here, and this guy thinks, I want to go here, and finally you don't go anywhere, you just stay wherever you are. That's just a simple example. Maybe you can compare it with your business model and see you can have a lot of things going on in your business. And that's when you talk to each other. When they have trust, they automatically open up their points. They automatically share their views and thoughts, and finally you resolve the conflict, right? And that's the second thing. If there is a healthy conflict in the team, that means that things are going well. And the third portion of the pyramid model comes the commitment. We're all committed to one single thing. If it's a family, maybe in a family we don't say that I'm committed to this and I'm going to achieve something, but you have something related to your family goals. You may think that I want to build a house, or you may think I want to buy a car. So that's personal things. But when it comes to business or when it comes to work, you have your company's vision or your company's goal or the vision statement, the mission statement. Once you know that, this commitment automatically builds. So it's the responsibility of each and every person in the team to know what is the company is doing or what is the team is trying to achieve. Once they are aware of that, that commitment part automatically gets filled in, right? And the fourth portion of the pyramid model, that is accountability. We confuse accountability with responsibility most of the time. Responsibility is something that you're supposed to do. Maybe you're hired for a job, maybe you're doing a job. That means that you're supposed to do that, only then you get your salary, right? Accountability is more than responsibility. You take something on your own. You feel that I own this. You have that sense of ownership. And that's when accountability comes into picture. And once you're accountable for your process or your team or the work that you're doing, you don't have to worry about the rest of the things. The numbers automatically comes, right? So accountability is the fourth pyramid. And the final portion, the crown of the pyramid, there comes the results. What are results? Results are the outcome of all the four pyramids, or how you have formed the trust and commitment and accountable, all these things, you get the result out of that. That's when you get the numbers, and that's when you see the statistics, that's when you see the metrics. And once you have that strong portion of trust and the accountability, everything is in place. You don't have to worry about the numbers. You don't have to worry about the results at all. You get the numbers automatically. Your team will take care of the numbers. You don't have to push them and say that these are all the numbers that I'm looking for. These are all the goals that we want to achieve. You don't even have to say that. Once your team is committed, they put all their effort and they don't want to let you down, and everything happens on its own. So the results are always the numbers that we see, and that is automatically there when you have the other four columns in set, right? So think about it. You may be working in a team. If you feel like if you want to share this video to someone who is working on a team, please feel free to do that. Thank you so much for watching. You have a good day. Bye for now.